So seeing as we have a quorum, I will call to order this school committee meeting of July 12th, 2021, our first in-person meeting, like completely in-person, since March 2020. And our agenda this evening is we will have one reports and discussion items concerning job descriptions for the Dean of Students, the Director of Finance and Operations, and the Senior Program Manager of Operations and Planning. And then we will adjourn to an executive session and then return for adjournment. So with that, I will just move to the job description positions, and I will introduce Dr. Hackett. Dr. Frank Hackett has joined us as of July 1st, and he brings with us many years of experience from most recently in Braintree, but before that in Pembroke, and then also from Maine as a superintendent and an assistant superintendent. So welcome.
Well, thank you. Thank you. It's good to be here. It's good to see the people who hired me actually in person. That was a strange process to be hired by people you've actually not met in person. So, but I appreciate your confidence that you put in me to bring me on board. And it's been a fast and furious couple of weeks. I can't even believe it's been 2 weeks now that I've actually been here. I got my office arranged today, got moved, came in, it was just happening. So people have been very gracious, and it's been great to learn a little bit more about the system and to meet some people and meet you this evening. So with that, some of these job descriptions, two of them anyway, have a history with you. The Dean of Student job description for the high school was actually in front of you quite some time ago. I believe that we traced it back to 2019 as part of the budget process and planning process at that point in time. The job description was brought to the seating school committee at that point, which was not all of you, but it was never approved. So tonight we're just bringing it back to you. There are a few changes to it from the last time that the school committee saw it. And just as a general statement, you have these job descriptions on your agenda for tomorrow night as well. So however you procedurally want to move on these is obviously up to you, but we wanted to also, I just wanted to note on that one, it was the Dean of Students, but that at some point the title did change to Dean of Student Life, so that is what you have in front of you tonight. The description we have is actually asking for licensure as a building administrator. It's not required for a Dean of Student position. It's not a title that's necessarily recognized by DESE as an administrative post, but we want the ability to have this person eventually be able to participate in the supervision evaluation process potentially at some point. So the licensure would be needed for that. Other than that, I think it's pretty straightforward. I think it's probably consistent with how you either remember the job description to be or what you would expect a Dean of Student Life to look like. So if there are questions, I would be happy to try to answer them. It would be even better if you have questions that I could track down tomorrow for tomorrow night's meeting, if you could get them to me ahead of time so I could check in with the high school if needed. The second job description that I just want to cover is the Director of Finance and Operations, which is a job description that does date back to, I believe, 96. Again, we wanted to bring this to you tonight because it is connected to the operations position, which we'll talk about in a second, but also just take an opportunity to make a few changes. Again, there are not substantive changes to this description. It's pretty much in line with what the law would say that this position is supposed to do and what it can do. I could answer any questions that you might have on that as well. And then finally, the position that is really substantively new. You had approved a operations coordinator position, I believe, as part of your budget process back in the spring. Just coming on board and just already having quite a few conversations with people even prior to my official start date, but having a chance to talk to a lot of you and having an opportunity to talk to a few parents and obviously central administration, just really trying to think about, is there a way that we could add more value to this position to try to meet some of the needs that I was hearing, especially in and around communication was clear. All districts struggle with communication. It's always a challenge to communicate well. So to have a position that can kind of focus on that, but also to have this embedded in just overall system improvement and really trying to think differently and be innovative about how, one, we do our business. So hopefully we can become more efficient, more effective for our consumers, which are our kids, as well as for our parents, so we can focus more on instructional quality, but also to provide some support across other units of what we do. The position as it was written was very heavily supportive of the Director of Finance and Operations, which is great, but I don't know that we need as much of that. I think that I'm hoping to kind of branch this position out a little bit more and have it touch a few more things. So that is how it's been written. It is, again, new to you, new to me. I'm excited about the opportunity to potentially have a position like this. I think it is, it's not something I've done elsewhere, but it's something that it kind of has evolved in just my work through both Braintree and Pembroke before that. I think these are, I think this position could really add value with the right person. So happy to answer any questions you might have about that.
So with that, I'll just open up the discussion. Mr. Hopcroft, did you have a question or a comment?
If no one else was speaking, I was gonna comment. First, welcome.
Thank you.
And it's nice to see you in person.
It's good to be here.
I think this looks really great. I think finding any opportunity we can to, continually look for ways to communicate more with our community, leverage new technologies, et cetera, meet them where they are, but also any opportunity we can find to innovate how we deliver and how we share best practices. And just every industry is changing, and this is too. And so I applaud the effort to start to build that into the team, to look for those people that have that eye and can help make that happen. So when I read this, I was like, yeah, this is great. Those are two of the top things that I cared about.
Thank you.
Mr. Brady.
Also, welcome. We're thank so you. Excited to have you here. And I just want to thank you for expanding this position. I think that was definitely the right step to take. To jump right in and do that, I think it's just impressive, and I appreciate you quickly kind of figuring out that that was a good opportunity and leveraging that. So thank you.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Want me to go?
Sure. Mr.
So
Nixon.
I'd be very interested to learn as this moves forward and we actually find somebody. I mean, perfect candidates are hard to find. There will always be some who have particular strengths in one area, less so in another, and that's perfectly okay. My sense is a lot of what we're looking for here, administration is doing in one way, shape, or form. We've got some folks in administration juggling multiple balls. It would be very interesting at some point, once we find that candidate, we have somebody on board, to learn more about how taking this on, to the extent this new individual is not just going to direct someone in doing it, but to actually do the work themselves. Right. I'd love to know how that then frees up some of the people who are doing a lot of this today, who then can do the job they're supposed to be doing in a more fulsome way, more efficiently, and so forth. There's a lot in here I know of some people who just jump on it when the request comes up. So I'm actually not just excited about the position, but in fact, it's going to give some people the freedom to kind of do what they're supposed to be doing in a, as I said, a more fulsome way. So I'd love to know more about that. It's going to be harder to know until you find the right candidate, I'm sure.
Right.
I appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you. It's truly, it is the right person for the position. I think the nice thing about it, there's no licensure requirement. So we have an opportunity not just to stay within the realm of education. We can, as we go out, we can broaden that search and find people from potentially from different industries too. So.
Well, and I think just like the job description has evolved as you have worked with the team here and gotten to know what our needs are and where we need to grow, I think that as you find that right person and they come into the job, they will also be able, I like the way the description is written, it will allow them to grow the position into what we need. And just to reiterate what Mr. Nixon is saying, just to be able to free other people up from some of these duplicate, as he said, there are so many things on this list that I know there are other members of our leadership team that are currently taking on, and we'll be able to do their jobs better when somebody else is able to take this on.
Perhaps even people in this room who might benefit perhaps from the position. So,
please approve.
And I will just add as well, I think everybody has said something of my thoughts, but I really do appreciate that this position has been broadened and that it now lends support to finance director and our technical side and our technology side, and then also especially on communications. So I think that outreach is excellent, and being proactive is really a good way to go. So. Good.
Okay. And I think my only question would be, do you have a timeline that you're thinking about on?
As soon as this committee agrees to vote it and approve the job description, we would post immediately and look to hire as soon as possible.
So I think you had mentioned earlier how we would treat the process around this, and I would say that we're looking at this as our first reading to see the positions this evening, and then it will be on the agenda for tomorrow night to come to a vote, if that is the direction that the committee would like to move. Any comments about Dean of Student Life or the Director of Finance and Business and Operations? Questions? Okay. Seeing none, then we are now, our next agenda item is for an executive session, and to move to the executive session, we will move to the executive session in order to discuss strategy related to collective bargaining, since to do so in person would be detrimental to the bargaining. And as such, we need a motion to move to executive session.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you very much. And so we will move to one of the front central office rooms, perhaps Dr. Hackett's office.
The relocated superintendent's
office. Yes. It's very nearby now.
It's a short walk.
Yes. And we'll return to open session after we've completed our discussion, and we'll end the meeting at that time. Thank you very much. from executive session at 7:17. And just to clarify, since I said this twice apparently before before we adjourn to executive session, our meeting tomorrow is a regularly scheduled school committee meeting, and it's in the morning at 9:30, not in the evening. So morning time, 9:30. And then otherwise, I believe that our only item left is to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn public session.
Second.
Thank you very much. Do we need a roll call vote?
Need a vote.
Just need a vote.
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Yes, thank you very much. Okay, have a good evening. Thank you, WinCam.
Thank you.